This is Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, one of the loudest, most intimidating places anywhere in sport. It's where the Oregon Ducks have won 23 consecutive home games, the longest streak in college football. Just a few yards from the banks of the Willamette River in one of the world's prettiest valleys. It grows quiet now as we stand for our national anthem.
Performed today by the Oregon Marching Band under the direction of Bob Pato.
Today, the Stanford Cardinal come north to see what they can do with the unbeaten and fifth-ranked Oregon Ducks. Now to Times Square Stadium, New York, John Saunders. Unbeaten college football teams are becoming as rare as green leaves in autumn. Last Saturday, 5 in the Pac-10. This Saturday, just 3 remain. In Pasadena, UCLA Bruins showed their might, laying the first loss to the Washington Huskies. Running back Deshaun Foster set a school rushing record with 301 yards. The Washington State Cougars wore down the Stanford Cardinal, handing Stanford a first loss, and the Cougars joined the top 25 rankings. Stanford is in tough again this week, trying to stay in the conference title hunt against the Oregon Ducks in Eugene. And as you look at the current standings, it's important to know that Oregon does not play Washington this year. But the Ducks do go to Pullman against Washington State next week. In today's schedule in the Pac-10, the game here would seem the most vital. UCLA at home with winless California. Washington State beat Montana State in a makeup game on Thursday night. Hello again, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson, and welcome to college football again on ABC Sports. We've heard sports announcers all of our lives ranting about teams controlling their own destiny. Well, the top three in the Pac-10 do that because it's this simple. Went out, and you win all. Perhaps even a chance, Tim Brandt, to go to the big one on January 3rd.
Well, I know these Oregon Ducks are thinking about that, Keith. As a matter of fact, the coaches told them this week, if they can go to 7-0 today, that's the best start here since 1933, and they would join the best of the best.
And we're going to be watching a couple of really good trigger guys today at quarterback.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct, and they're very much alike. They're big, strong quarterbacks. Joey Harrington had a lot of pressure on him early. They called him Joey Heisman. Right now, he's only fourth in this conference in passing efficiency. Not that great? Well, he's a winner, I'll tell you that, a pocket passer. Today, he just has to be patient, use all his weapons, and he'll be fine. On the other side of the line of scrimmage, Randy Fossani of Stanford is an outstanding quarterback. Same size, good passer, but he adds the element of run, escapability. That could cause some problems today for the Oregon defense. And I want to remind everybody this. 6 of the last 7 champions in this conference started seniors at quarterback. These two are seniors.
Right.
The Pac-10 could have used a couple of Nash units this week, particularly for the defensive people, because a lot of hurt going on around the conference. Here's Todd Harris with that story.
Well, Keith and Tim, everyone has injuries by the middle of October, but these two teams have been hit particularly hard, especially on the defensive side. So if you're the Cardinal offense looking for a vulnerable spot on the Oregon D, look no further than the secondary. Leading tackler safety Keith Lewis is questionable with an ankle injury. Right corner Steve Smith missed practice all week with a knee injury. And as bad as that sounds, it may be worse for Stanford. Their injuries are centered around the front seven. The Cardinal come to Autzen Stadium without the services of their sack leader, tackle Matt Leonard. Gabriel, Freeman, Friedrichs, Wire, and Carter also hurt, but they will play. Now each team's defense will have to rely on some untested names, and they could also use the help of their respective offensive units to help keep them off the field. Keith.
All right, Todd, thanks very much. Stanford has won the toss, and they will take the football. So we'll see the Cardinal on offense first with Ryan Wells, who's he's tender, and Brian Allen, the tailback, returning the kick. And it's Siegel, Jared Siegel, kicking it off for the Oregon Ducks. Those uniforms are forbidding even in the daylight. And we're on at Eugene. Brian Allen from the 1 yard line. And taken down short of the 15. Downfield coverage very strong for the speedy Ducks. And they stop him short of the 15-yard line. The starting lineup for the Stanford Cardinals, quarterback Randy Fasani, the mover of the offense, responsible for 18 points a game and 12 touchdowns so far this season. He is a gunslinger. He sometimes will take a chance and pay for it, but most of the time he is just a big old tough competitor.
And that's a good point. That's a good point, Keith. We have to watch that early. He gave away a couple of easy ones last week. He's got to take better care of the ball today against Oregon.
Kerry Carter will start at the tailback position or the prime running back position, and he gets the ball. He's going to throw a forward pass. Downfield, he lets it go. Intended for the tight end. He gets tangled up. Brett Pierce with Gary McCraw, but there is no flag on the play.
Well, they were going after the big guy early here. They wanted that 6'6 tight end going against McGraw, and that's because Lewis isn't in the ball game. Pretty good coverage that time. Stuck with him. A lot of contact. Back judge said, let him play. Good no call. We've seen a lot of that this year. Good way to start off, though, Keith. Let's loosen that defense right away and say we're not afraid to go deep.
It is second down and 10 from the 14-yard line. Fasani turns to throw. He puts it down the middle, and that might get a flag. Nope. That does not get a flag either. Rasuli Webster and Brett Pierce, they were looking for the tight end for the second successive play. The backs and receivers, Brian Allen, steady at tailback. And a little man, Luke Powell, shows up as a big-time player, 5'8". He's kind of like Troy Walters, kind of a player. Offensive front, Chambers, Harris, they're good. All these people up front are seniors, and they're all very steady players. Tao Johnson now is into the ball game along with Jamie McCullen on third down and 10. The Stanford goes with four wideouts. Oregon was across the line of scrimmage in a hurry, but no flags again. The pass is thrown upfield for a first down to Damian McCullen. And Stanford will move the chains to the 29-yard line on that pass completion.
Since they were 0 for 2 passing right away, they knew they were going to pass this time. They bring it right off the bottom of the screen, and it's coming hard. Now they pick up that outside blitz, and Fasani makes this play work by buying time. The escapability we talked about earlier, he steps up in the pocket, finds his receiver, moves the chains. He is a cool customer. He's a senior, and he's tough.
And it's first down for the Stanford Cardinal. And fumble! Stanford keeps the ball. Covering it is Fasani, the man that didn't come away from center. Second down and 12 for the Cardinal. Hand the ball off to Brian Allen. And Allen is taken down by, look like, Moretti, the linebacker, who got a piece of him as he went by.
Keith, you talked about Darryl Wright starting at right end. We were wondering why Quinn Dorsey wasn't in there. He is now. There, as a matter of fact, the two are alternating. Now Dorsey goes back out. Wright comes in. So I think we're going to see a lot of that all day. Keep the ends fresh so they can put pressure on Fasani.
Ball is on the 32-yard line. It is third down and 7 for Stanford. No pressure on Fasani. The pass is away, and it is caught. It is caught for a first down by Brian Allen out of the backfield, and Allen makes a big play out of it as the Oregon tackling gets a bit sloppy, and he breaks two arm tackles and moves the football to the Oregon side of the field, all the way down to the Ducks' 37-yard line.
It's a situation where Brett Pierce, the tight end, probably wanted the pass to come his way. He drags all the way across. Here he is. He's going to go like this. They don't throw him the ball, but I want you to watch what happens after they throw underneath of him to Allen. All right, here goes Fasani. He throws underneath. Now watch the tight end turn around and come get a block, the block that frees him. Great balance by Allen. He gets the first down and a lot more.
31 yards on the play. First down at the Oregon 37-yard line. Stanford beaten last week. They literally gave away 21 points to Washington State. Going for the bundle. Deep pass downfield completed to Teo Johnson. He's inside the 5-yard line. It'll be first down and goal Stanford at the Oregon 3. They went against Steve Smith, who's playing dinged up. And Teo Johnson, a 6'7", 245-pound, better known as a basketball player, but on his way to becoming a real good football player.
Well, they're working on that size differential, too. They know he's a great athlete. He's got speed, but he also has that size. Smith is 6'1". He's got good position. He's got leverage, but he cannot go up with Teo Johnson.
Smith leaves the ball game. He's sore, remember, and did not practice all week. Kerry Carter, the big back, is in the deep back position, gets the ball, slashes at the right side, goes to the goal line, Ducks battle with him, and stop him. He did not make it in.
With Brian Allen, you get a small back, 5'10", 200, explosive, with great balance. We saw it earlier. Now you come in with Kerry Carter. He's 6'2", 235. That's like a hammer and a sledgehammer. That's like a thoroughbred and a workhorse. Carter just would not go down with that size. He's explosive and powerful, tackle to tackle.
They're a foot short of the goal line. Second down and goal for Stanford.
I'd go right back to Carter. Either that or quarterback sneak.
Fullback, Casey Moore. Touchdown, Stanford. And Autzen Stadium grows quiet.
Casey Moore's first touchdown of the year. He's 240 pounds. They're banging in there big time. Keep in mind, Moore's the guy that fumbled last week. He's thought about it all week. He said, hey, guys, I want to come back. I want to repay you, because they thought they let one get away. And here he scores.
Mike Baselli is in for the point. That snap was low and hard, but handled nicely.
Partner, they made it look too easy.
Yep, they did. I remember a long time ago that happened in a Super Bowl game, and an old friend of mine turned and said, false confidence. We'll see. 9 plays, 86 yards. Stanford goes to the lead. The Stanford Cardinals zipping right down the field very tidily. Thank you very much. There was only one wobble in there, and that was a fumble that was covered by the quarterback, Fasani. Now the Cardinal kicks it off, the ball bounding down the field, and it's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to be Oregon taking the ball up at the 35-yard line. The quarterback for the Oregon Ducks, they call him Captain Comeback. Joey Harrington has led 8 fourth quarter comebacks for wins in the past 3 seasons, and there is no question he is the man for the Oregon Ducks. They're still huddled on the sidelines. Now they break out of the huddle and come to the play.
Joey Harrington just has to get everybody involved early. He's got to use all his weapons. Cannot try to do it all himself.
So the first snap for Oregon, trailing 7-0. Let's see if they've got the fast start in their game plan this week. Ball is thrown quickly out to Jason Willis, and Jason Willis will pick up a first down. Gain 12 yards on the first play of the ball game. First and 10 for the Ducks. Their ball up on the 47-yard line, and Harrington going down the middle with it. He's got Keenan Howry wide open, and Howry dives for the corner. He's out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Jason White got just enough of him to keep him from going in for the score. First and goal for the Ducks. Harrington splits over the left side, gets inside the 5, will pick up a yard on the play. Very quick recovery defensively by Coy Wire for the Cardinal. The Stanford defense, the leading sack man, tackle Matt Leonard, not here. Back problems. Roomy tackle Trey Freeman has a bad ankle, but he's playing. Linebackers, this is a very good group, but as we told you, Gabriel is wounded some, and that means in the defensive secondary, Tank Williams moves out of that group and up as an outside backer with Jason White starting at free safety. Second down and goal for Oregon, just inside the 5-yard line.
There's Tank Williams right up the top of your screen. Looks like he's coming hard on the edge.
Harrington wants to throw, does, touchdown, Oregon. Keenan Harry. Jared Siegel for the extra point try for the Oregon Ducks. Joey Harrington holds it. Snap is good, hold is good, kick is good. Four plays, 65 yards, a minute, 19 seconds, and we're rolling downhill at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, all even at 7. They're replacing the battery.
Oregon, Stanford tied at 7. Here's your Nissan Game Solutions for Stanford. Well, the Cardinal have to move the ball because their offense is going to be their best defense. They've got to stay on the field, keep Harrington off because the Cardinal defense is banged up. Top tacklers are out, and even when they're healthy, the defense gives up 28 points a game. For Oregon, well, Joey Harrington has to be patient, use all of his weapons. So far, all he's needed was Keenan Howery, who was involved in all three plays. But don't forget, he's got Peel, Morris, and Smith. That's a vicious attack, and right now they're working on Joey Harrington's neck.
Might have a little stinger going there. That's not very good news. That kickoff is short all the way out to the 12-yard line where Brian Allen has it for Stanford, and he's going to break a big one.
He's gone.
He may be gone. Bowman's a man that can shot at him, and he shoves him out of bounds.
Wow.
Rashad Bowman tracked him down and kept him from going all the way. So Brian Allen, who can hurry, almost found the end zone with that one, carrying the ball all the way down to the Oregon 13-yard line. We may need a triple-digit scoreboard before we get through with this. That was a 76-yard return.
Just following his blockers, weaving in and out, getting a lot of white jerseys in front of him, and then it was a foot race, and of course, Bauman had a better pursuit angle, outran him, got him down, but what a way to start this drive.
Big back Kerry Carter is the beat man. He's in there with Casey Moore. Fasani sets him up and gives it to Carter. And Carter trying to bounce outside. The coverage is good. Coming over is Rashad Bowman to make the tackle.
Keith, in Stanford's first drive, they went 80 yards in the air. Now they're going to try to establish that running game. And what Oregon's doing is they'll go 8 guys in the box if they say 2 backs. They'll go 9 guys in the box if they say 2 backs and 2 tight ends. And that puts a lot of pressures on the corners. And this is an Oregon defense. It gives up about 300 yards in the air a game.
Rashad Bowman had to go off the field to get a new shoe. That puts Stephen Moore in there at quarterback. Let's see if Fasani sees it. He looks that way. He goes that way. And the pass is completed down to about the 6-yard line to Luke Powell. Luke Powell, little man, making his first catch of the day. It is third down from the 6-yard line. And Teo Johnson, the big guy, is in, replacing Powell, and he's up there at the top of the picture. And Fasani gives the ball to Kerry Carter. Touchdown. So Carter gets a couple of blocks on the left side and walks in. And just that quickly, Stanford goes back to the lead. Eric Heitman, the music composing, piano playing, big left guard, all 6'4", 295 pounds of him from Katy, Texas.
Keith, look at this. Look at all these defenders right here in what they call the box. They think their run is coming, and then these guys are coming hard. But the play is called perfectly. They still go to this corner and outnumber them. But Oregon expected the run. They got it and couldn't stop them.
Mike Maselli for the extra point. And he got it. And so every time Stanford's seen the football, they've scored. Now it's Oregon's turn again to see if they can answer again. At 8:24 to go in the first quarter, 14-7 Cardinals. Yard line for the Oregon Ducks. They went for the touchdown and four plays a little while ago. Let's see what they do now. Stanford's made some defensive changes. They've had time to do much. They pitch the ball back. And it is Maurice Morris turning around the corner, trying to get him outside, but there are three Cardinals over there to defend him, and Austin Lee was the man who got it. 2 yards, 3 yards on the play, three. Second down and seven for the Ducks.
There's Keenan Howery way up top.
Favor the ground game. Morris again coming around the right side. He's got a first down. He's knocked out of bounds up at the 41-yard line by Tank Williams. First down for the Ducks at their own 41-yard line. Stanford leading 14-7. Here's Harrington rolling out, buying time, lets it go. Down the side, good to Justin Peel. They're not going to give it to him because he didn't have control of the ball when it went out of bounds. Second down and 10. Little quick pop to the sidelines. Keenan Howery. Keenan Howery battling over there, trying to get something. He gave away some in his struggle. The gain will be up to about the 45-yard line, but Ryan Fernandez got a hold of him and wouldn't turn him loose. Mike Bellotti standing there in the center. Mike has lost his mustache.
Keith, they move Tank Williams to inside backer.
Passes away to the sidelines. Passes completed to the fullback out of the backfield. That's close to a first down.
And that's Tank Williams who made that tackle, following him out of the backfield.
It looks like it might be a first down.
We just told Keith, we just told you they moved Tank Williams in inside linebacker, so he has now read through the backs for his keys. He reads that they release, gets out there quickly, and makes a nice break on Harrington's pass to make this tackle.
First down for the Ducks. It's on the Stanford side, just inside the Stanford 49. Harrington gives to Morris. There was pretty good penetration as Coy Wire, number 22, came over and took him down. Second down and 8 here in Eugene for the Oregon Ducks. They got a couple of pretty good quarterbacks on display here, too. Joey Harrington, who hung over Madison Square Garden much of the summer, turns and gives the ball to Ontario Smith. And Smith slips and slides and almost popped out of there. Harrington gets it away. He's got it. First down, Oregon, inside the 20-yard line to Keenan Howery.
How about both these teams just running up and down the field?
Harrington back, pressure coming, pass away. Oh, my goodness. It's Justin Peel had the ball. He didn't look at home. He turned to look for somebody to be around him, and he was so far out there, he was all by himself and lonesome and dropped it.
They gambled and came with the blitz.
Second down. Down the middle it goes to Peel. Go right back to him and touchdown. Siegel, a freshman from Sacramento, for the extra point for the Oregon Ducks, and it's good. We're all even again at 14. Living the life of a squire. Backed up against the National Forest Preserve. Not bad. High hanging kick. Down to the one. And here comes Brian Allen again. And this time the Ducks hunt him down at the 20-yard line. Those are three terrific football games. First down for Stanford at the 20-yard line. Fasani back. Pulls it down. He's a big, tough guy out of Granite Bay, California. And he's all the way out to the 40-yard line before Wes Mallard finally brings him down.
Boy, Stanford spread the field, went sideline to sideline, four wideouts to spread the defense thin, unclog the middle, and let him go up in it. Now you'll see there's not eight in the box anymore because they have all the receivers wide. And then look at this, the blocking up front, he finds the hole, escapes, and there's nobody in the secondary because they're wide with the receivers.
They go double toward the bottom of your picture this time and put a man in motion the other way. Fasani back. Passes away, passes complete to Kerry Carter, and he's hit by two Ducks at the 46-yard line. Kevin Mitchell and David Moretti, linebackers, brought him down. It'll be second down and about five.
I never thought that conditioning would be a factor in late October. But here we are, the third Saturday in October, and these teams are going up and down the field so fast, conditioning, in fact, may be a factor.
But it's a cool day. It was 51 degrees when we started.
That's why you never worry about it in October.
Jim Springer, the referee, as the umpire jumps in there and throws a flag, Dennis Angel. So it's second down and a little bit less than 10 yards now for Stanford after that penalty. And it's a running play out of the backfield, and it's Casey Moore, the big fullback, who doesn't give up. He just keeps on pounding, and very poor tackling by the Oregon Ducks. Finally, Dave Moretti brings him down.
Yeah, that's the key, Keith. You're right. I mean, it wasn't that the play was that fancy. It wasn't designed that great. There was really not much complication to it. But this is just poor tackling. Now, everybody blocks down. They try to get him on the edge, but there's Oregon. One tackle, two tackle. Here comes another tackle. That's three missed, four missed. Nobody wrapping, nobody holding on, nobody grabbing cloth and taking them down. Great effort by Casey Moore. Poor tackling by Oregon.
Ball goes first down on the Oregon 48-yard line for Stanford. We're still in the first quarter, and we've had 28 points scored already. Brian Allen goes in motion. Hassani is back. Throws quickly to the far sidelines, and the defender slip. Ryan Wells made the catch, and Wells is going to put the ball down inside the 30-yard line.
Keith, it is Keith Lewis who's playing with a bad wheel. He's got a bad ankle, and he couldn't plant. Their speedster is right here. That's Luke Powell. They're going to send him and then come back under into the vacated area. Now watch. Here comes number six. That's Lewis. His right ankle is bad. Now watch. He's going to try to plant it. Watch what happens. Woo. He just overruns the play, can't stop fast enough to break down, and they move the chains.
First down, 29-yard line. It's Brian Allen. And the Ducks get him. Short of the line of scrimmage by two, Rashad Bowman leading the tacklers. The ball is back on the 31-yard line, a loss of two, second down and 12 for the Cardinal. As Luke Powell, little man, moving toward the middle, he goes down into the middle. Fasani throws back, drop for the tight end, Matt White. Fasani with pressure, got a block, got away, pass no good. Ball is on the Oregon 31-yard line. Stanford's going. You got Wells and Powell over here together. Fasani with a deep drop. Down the middle, going deep. It is caught and dropped. Teo Johnson had it and then took a whack to the side of the head, and the ball came out. It looked like McGraw and Webster with the two Ducks covering, and I think Webster is the man that knocked it out. Harrington quickly pops one upfield. It's good to Jason Willis, and Jason Willis with that little juke step almost popped out of there. Going big. No, wasn't available. Pulls it down, goes for the first down, tiptoes down the sideline, and has a first down. First down and 10 inside the 40-yard line. Harrington going deep this time for Harry. Touchdown. Harrington holds it, and the kick is good. And so for the first time today, the Oregon Ducks, ranked fifth in the country and undefeated, have taken the lead 21-14. Siegel to kick it off. Not a very good kick. It's short and high and hanging and goes out of bounds. It'll be Stanford ball up on the 35-yard line. So here comes Stanford now trying to answer from the 35-yard line. Fasani hands the ball away to Kerry Carter. And Carter bumps in there for a couple of yards. Second down, call it seven. Asani with a little quick drop outside to Kerry Carter out of the backfield, and he's got a first down and then some. Finally, they throw him down. Here they go again. The ball is down to the 32-yard line before.